Greetings. What are Christians to do as Europe collapses under socialism and Islam? What are Christians to do as persecution of Christians increases around the world? Ephesians 6:10. Finally, be strong in the Lord and in his mighty power. Put on the full armor of God so that you can make your stand against the devil's schemes. When this mentions armor, I always think of knights and soldiers. But pay attention to what the context, the next verse, says. For our struggle is not against flesh and blood, but against the rulers, against the authorities, against the powers of this world's darkness, and against the spiritual forces of evil in the heavenly realms. Not against flesh and blood means the rulers, authorities, and powers cannot be flesh and blood people. If your particular flavor of Christianity does not believe in Satan or demons, I have to ask you, do you even believe in God? You must be consistent if you pursue the truth, brother. You cannot say you believe in Jesus if you think Satan does not exist. Otherwise, who tempted Jesus? For our struggle is not against flesh and blood, but against the rulers, the authorities, against the powers of this world's darkness, and against the spiritual forces of evil in the heavenly realms. Our battle is against, evil spirits. It is the Christian fear and shame of that reality that has crippled their power for generations. Don't say evil spirits, or they'll think you're a witch doctor or worship Bigfoot. Listen to C.S. Lewis and Mere Christianity, because even he mentions the reality of Satan, and how during his lifetime, mention of Satan or the devil would trigger mocking of a red, horn-headed character with a long pointed tail. Satan's mindless minions have run cover for the demon for many generations now, and Allah, Satan, needed that cover for centuries since Jesus defeated him on the cross of crucifixion. For our struggle is not against flesh and blood, but against the rulers, against the authorities, against the powers of this world's darkness, and against the spiritual forces of evil in the heavenly realms. You must know who your enemy is if you are to fight them at their attack, even at their approach to deceive you. Therefore, take up the full armor of God so that when the day of evil comes, you will be able to stand your ground, and having done everything, to stand. Armor protects you and covers your weak spots. Armor enables you to stand and face the enemy with confidence. But just as our enemies are not flesh and blood, our armor is not wood and steel. Stand firm then with the belt of truth fastened around your waist, with the breastplate of righteousness arrayed. Your belt keeps your pants up. It prevents you from being embarrassed. Love the truth and know the truth. Bind the truth around you tightly. Stand firm then with the belt of truth fastened around your waist, with the breastplate of righteousness arrayed. The breastplate of righteousness protects your heart and inner organs. Righteousness is your protection from temptations. Proverbs 4:23. Keep your heart with all vigilance, for from it flow the springs of life. Matthew 12:34. You brood of vipers, how can you who are evil say anything good? For out of the overflow or abundance of the heart, the mouth speaks. Proverbs 16:23. The heart of the wise instructs his mouth and adds persuasiveness to his lips. Stand firm then with the belt of truth fastened around your waist, with the breastplate of righteousness arrayed. and with your feet fitted with the readiness of the gospel of peace. Another translation, and your feet shod with the preparation of the gospel of peace. And another, and as shoes for your feet, having put on the readiness given by the gospel of peace. These shoes are made for walking, and going, and teaching, and doing. And as shoes for your feet, having put on the readiness given by the gospel of peace. The gospel prepares you, makes you ready, ready to give an answer for what you believe. 2 Timothy 4:2, preach the word, be prepared in season and out of season, reprove, rebuke, and encourage with every form of patient instruction. For the time is coming when people will not endure sound teaching, but having itching ears, they will accumulate for themselves teachers to suit their own passions. And with your feet fitted with the readiness of the gospel of peace, in addition to all this, take up the shield of faith with which you can extinguish all the flaming arrows of the evil one. Faith is not and does not mean blind faith. Using your mind, your brain, does not threaten God in any way. The God of the Bible encourages honest, intellectual pursuit. The reason atheism runs into the ditch is they begin their logic from a false assumption. There is not and cannot be anything which physical senses cannot detect or discern. If only they were consistent in that position, they would reject the fallacy of the multiverse, which can never be observed or measured. Ephesians 6:17, and take the helmet of salvation and the sword of the Spirit, which is the Word of God. There is a reason Muslims fear the Bible. The demon they listen to fears the Bible. What are Christians to do as Europe collapses under socialism and Islam? What are Christians to do as persecution of Christians increases around the world? We are to walk and live and love as God commanded us to do. This life is fleeting. This time on earth is temporary. This civilization is doomed. And while we struggle in this life, we seek our real home with Jesus and God the Father. We should look forward to and seek the bridegroom. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.